All right, friends, I hope everybody's having a really good day. Super, super excited about what God is doing. The Lord recently just spoke to me. I was in a time of prayer, and it was a corporate prayer meeting, and I just started writing down some prophetic thoughts that the Lord gave me. And when I was done at this corporate prayer meeting, I wrote down 10 different things that God gave me, just one after another. It was just probably over a 20-minute time span that God just gave me these 10 different thoughts. And as I just kind of was thinking, I said, man, I ought to do a prophetic release Monday through Friday on Periscope. So this is Monday. And the first two things that God spoke to me about, I'm going to share today. And I'm excited about just what God is doing. And recently, in another time of prayer, the Lord started speaking to me about that we're in a season that we're going to experience and see some really amazing things. That I honestly feel the last 2 months of 2018 and the first 2 months of 2019, that God is really going to put the accelerator on some people. A lot of people are going to start moving into some things that there's going to be an acceleration time. And it was neat, after I've really been releasing this word and praying about this word, some major voices in the body of Christ have been actually feeling the same thing. And it's so encouraging when you hear a prophetic word and you release the prophetic word, and then major voices in the body start saying something very similar. You know, make sure that you don't get caught up when pure voices, true voices, are sharing the same thing. You know, now there are some people that come in and may pirate that word or parrot that word, but don't ever get caught up thinking that when you see pure voices saying that. So it was really been encouraging, and a lot of people are talking about the last few months of 2018 going into 2019, how it's going to be just a good season, and it is. I even remember in 2017, I was so excited. If you don't know me, I'm excited a lot. But I was excited about 2018, and the Lord said 2018 is going to be a really good year for a lot of people in the body, but it is a setup for 2019. And 2018 was amazing for us, and I thought, God, thank you so much for what you're building in the kingdom. And so even get ready for that. So let's jump into this. The first two words that I heard, the first one was unchartable. And when God gave me that word, I got super excited, and I was like, Lord, you know, this is an amazing word, unchartable. And then it was like, this is the vision that I got from this word, that there are people, and I hope that you are one of these people, that they were just talking about what God was doing in their life. And it's like, in my vision, I could just see people laughing. They had so much joy. They had so much peace that they couldn't even get the words out to explain it. How many of you know sometimes God does stuff that is so good and so powerful, you really can't even explain it? You know, I was talking to some people recently about how good God has been to us. And when I say God's been good, let me explain it. We have went through severe warfare and times and different things. When God pulls you through, that's when you know God is good. And I'm just so thankful for him. And so these people in this vision I had, they couldn't even explain it. They couldn't even put it into human terms. Some would laugh, some would cry. And then the Lord spoke to me and said, what I am about to do in some people, it will be unchartable. It will be off the charts. And God, as I'm getting older and I'm maturing in the Lord, the thing that is so great with God is he's showing me his heart and his love. When I say blessings, a lot of people, they always think materialistic things. I'm telling you, there is a love that we can have in God that far surpasses any of that. And God, when he speaks to you, how he is stabilizing people and movements and moving generals forward to lead, that is so powerful, that is so good. And so the first word of the 10 I'll be releasing this week is unchartable. The Lord said he's about to do some things in some people and through some people, in churches, in businesses, in ministries, in movements that will be unchartable. You know, one of my heroes is Apostle Dutch Sheets. and he's praying for a billion souls. He is praying for more souls to come into the kingdom over the next, you know, 5, 6, 10 years than we've ever seen. That's what he prays for. That is unchartable. You know, when I pray for people in Roar Apostolic Network, in our Roar family, I pray that their marriages, their parenting is unchartable. You know, it's just off the charts. You know, my wife and I, our marriage is better than it's ever been. And I never even thought I could have a marriage as good as our marriage is. My wife and I are in a place in ministry that I really never thought we could be at. But I'm telling you, he is unchartable. And what he wants to do, see, we preach and say this a lot at Roar Church, but there's no limit to God, so there's no limit to us. There's no measure to God, so there should be no measure to us. And when I look at where we are in our life right now, I give God all glory, but he has taken us to a place that is unchartable. I never thought 10 years ago I could be where I'm at now with God, with my relationship with God moving forward. And I'm telling you, the best is yet to come. So many people have limited God in their minds, on their business, on their marriage. I mean, it's so funny. I was talking to somebody recently, and him and his spouse were talking, and they were kind of like, we never thought we would be married past so many years, so we really don't know what to do now. They honestly went into marriage thinking they wouldn't last that long. And he said, now we're in uncharted territories. And so I was helping them. There's some people, your business went to a place that you never thought it would be. You've got to add on to your building. You have to grow what you're doing because you're in uncharted territories. So many people that I see in ministry, I love this. They're like, I never thought I would be at the place that I'm at ministering, who I'm ministering with. It's unchartable. God has more for you than you could ever even imagine. Second word I want to share with you is aggressive blessings. When I heard this in my spirit, I straight up received it, y'all. I was like, aggressive blessings. I love the way that sounds. And then here's that, when I heard this, now you got to understand, when you say unchartable and aggressive blessing, some people, their mind goes off what they think the word is supposed to look like. The way God showed it to me, it's a little different. Aggressive blessings. When I think of blessings now, as I'm getting a little bit more mature, not older, but more mature, aggressive blessing is having a stronger marriage, is having I got three young children, having a closer relationship with them having a closer relationship with God. A blessing is seeing Roar Church members move into what they're called to do. See people in Roar Apostolic Network move into what they're called to do more. Those are a blessings. And what the Lord was showing me is that over these next 4 months, we are about to see some people who have aggressive blessings. I was reading Philippians and Ephesians in the Passion Translation the other day, and there were so many things about in Ephesians 1, how God wants to bring an allotment to you. In Ephesians 6:10, that God wants to do an explosive work in you to do it through you. In Philippians, they're so good. But one place I read that got me, it said that God wants to do such a powerful work in you that it is an illustration to the world, an advertisement of his glory and power. My friends, God is looking for somebody that their life is an illustration for him. That's what testimonies are about. I wasn't at Roar Church Sunday. I was at the Ramp Chattanooga, but they were talking about a young man, Cameron, who I'm so proud of. He was sharing about what God's done in his life in a year. And my wife said, Joe, he was sharing, and it was so powerful. He was just talking about the goodness of God, what God has done in that young man's life over the last 365 days is unchartable. It's unchartable. And this is what's coming. Aggressive blessings are coming to some people. Some people, listen, when you keep moving forward with God, he is going to keep moving forward with you. That's what James 4:8 is all about. It says when we draw near to God, when we make a step towards God, he's making a step towards us. He is that loving father that when you call out to him, he will come in. That's where Jeremiah 33:3 comes. Call unto me, I will answer and show you great and mighty things. We are pursuing God. When God comes, when God moves towards you, there's aggressive blessings coming. Because when you get closer to God, you get everything that God has. As an apostle, when I go into churches and I go and minister, I bring in and manifest the kingdom of God. Whenever I go places, people always say, Joe, when you came in, you brought so much. You impacted us so much. That's what we do. When you go to your job, you go and you actually bring so much that when you enter into a business, you bring the favor and the blessings of God. And so you must understand, for the people that have been pushing through a hard season, there was aggressive blessings. Think about the children of Israel when they left Egypt. They were in bondage. They were in slavery. They were under a taskmaster. When they finally got in the promised land, aggressive blessings started happening. And now when you get aggressive blessings, listen to me, that does not take out the work ethic. That does not take out you working. It means a lot of times the years of your labor have finally solidified a foundation for you to move forward. I hope you understood that word right there, because that was good. A lot of times people want to be blessed. They want to sit on the couch and God bring them bonbons and money. But what you got to understand is God's going to fill your mind full of wisdom and insight to create sustainable income that you can bless. The reason you need more money is not for you. It is to advance the kingdom of God. It is to advance what God is doing in the earth. So recently I had a prophetic vision of a long hallway, and there was a door in the hallway, right in the middle of the hall was a door. And as I opened the door, I took a step up and there was another door in the hallway, and they were straight ahead. They weren't on the sides. And in this vision, I kept walking down this hallway and opening these doors one after another. They were right in front of me. Aggressive blessings are about to line up in front of you. The wisdom and the favor of God is blessings. God is going to give you the missing piece to a puzzle. He is going to give you the missing information you need to move forward in your dream, your destiny, your purpose, your building. I believe that there are some business owners that you're going to have breakthrough seasons just month after month. Things are going to happen. Aggressive blessings are coming. Any good father wants to pour out his love and blessings on his children that he knows will steward them well. Very important to this word right here. You have to make sure that you are stewarding what God is wanting you to do well. When God blesses you with something, steward that blessing, steward that word, and watch how other blessings start to come. My wife and I have started so many new ministries and different things that we're always working on in projects. It's because we steward. When something's not moving forward in our life, I don't blame anybody. I don't say, God, where is it? I look and see, have I stewarded what he wanted me to do last well? So I hope that right there helped you. The two words is unchartable and aggressive blessings, and those are coming to the children of God who have been moving forward with God and have been stewarding well the things that he has given them. Man, I hope this helped. I'm going to do this at 8:30 every day this week. Jump on, share. We're going to have a good time. These were the first two of 10 prophetic thoughts that God gave me in one setting. He just lined them out for me. There was 10 of them. So I appreciate y'all being on here. Two websites I want to tell you about. JoJoDawson.net. It's got all of our scheduling. It's got all of our videos and blogs. RoarU.TV. It's got a bunch of apostolic prophetic training. We're about to add purpose, destiny, and dream, a section on there for that. And then also we release a video every day on YouTube, Monday through Friday. In the next 2 weeks, we're going to release a video every day at 1:30. Go on there. Just type in JoJo Dawson. Go to the channel. Subscribe. Good stuff. Thank y'all for being here with me. God bless.